Gilbert, welcome back. We're back again.
Great to be back again.
Fantastic to have you. So today we're talking about motivation. Now, in your role as the mental skills coach for the All Blacks, I'm sure you have days with the players where they just don't have the motivation to get on the field and do their best. And motivation is something that we all need in the jobs that we do. So tell us a little bit, how do you get these players to be in that right headspace when they're having a bad day or they just don't want to be where they are? What do you do?
It's really interesting. You know, motivation is a hugely researched topic, probably a misunderstood topic, really. I've always understood motivation to be giving someone a reason for doing something. So when that reason's very, very strong, then the energy and application that you apply to the tasks that you have to do is strong as well. But there are days, as you say, where you get up and you sometimes lose sight of what it is and why you're doing things, and that energy wanes. And to be fair, there's probably more days in the year where you get up and you don't feel like doing what you've got to do than you do. And that in itself is an amazing statement. Like athletes, there's more days where they don't feel like training than they do. And business, there's more days where you don't feel like doing your work than you do. So it's how do you actually ensure that you can actually be productive in those moments? So if we get the understanding that and the mindset that, wow, that this is a day that I can really make a difference to the things that I want to achieve, then I can apply more energy, and quite often the thought processes I have around it can catapult me into a different level of engagement around the activity I need. And sometimes I can also look at identifying when those high risk days are for me, or those moments in a week or in a month where I'm most likely to have my motivation wane, and I can set structures around me that actually can enable me to actually be pushed and to give me the energy to move forward in a much more positive way.
So self-awareness of yourself is so linked in to self-motivation, clearly.
Well, self-awareness is the master skill. Mm. You know, if you're not aware of yourself, then you are never going to be aware of others, and you're not going to be aware of what's happening around you. So your understanding self is a huge part of the motivation and performance puzzle. And setting up a structure that enables you to do that accurately and clearly is an important structure to have in place.
So if you're an agent, a real estate agent, and you know you've spent a lot of time doing prospecting and appraisals, etc., and you're just not, you know, you game day isn't happening for you, you're just not hitting your numbers, motivations get low, you start to question whether you should be in the industry or not, What do you do?
Well, we talk about motivation being something that's linked to focus, and one of the biggest derailers in performance is that your focus can go in one of two directions. Is if I get consumed by an outcome where, you know, I want these listings and I want to hit these targets, I want to hit these goals, and my mindset becomes consumed with that, what it does is it actually takes my thoughts or my focuses away from the processes, which are the things that I have to do, that if I do with great energy and great accuracy and with great execution will lead to those outcomes. So what we've got to drive in those people that have challenges there is a strong on-task and in-process focus, a strong on-task and in-process. So I get up today and I understand that if I do these tasks and I connect to them powerfully and I pursue them vigorously, that the outcomes will take care of themselves. Because if the pendulum swings more to the outcome focus, it actually paralyzes you, and you stop, and you get stuck, and you sit behind the computer, and you don't pick the phone up, and you don't go and meet people, and you don't talk with energy and vigor in that particular way. So really, really ensuring that we can drive an on-task and in-process focus every day, identify the times when that wobbles a little bit so you can put support structures around you, will help you sort of navigate your way through the inevitable ups and downs that occur for all of us in our day-to-day endeavour.
Have you ever had the occasion where you've had to say to one of your elite sports people, do you know what, you just need to go and have a break and then come back?
Yeah, I think it comes back to your question of understanding self. You know, we strongly advocate that if all you do is work, 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 work all the time, then you'll burn out. And you can't do that. So we've understood that, you know, getting a balanced existence is a combination of, yes, understanding that you've got to do your task and you've got to stay in process, but You've got to have stimulation and learning as well. So you excite the brain in some way, and then you have fun. And the best fun is sometimes fun that's not planned, but it just happens because of the way in which you've structured your world, the people that you meet. And I've got some friends that are just naturally funny, and I love to meet them and be with them because they make me laugh. And I know that I can go to different places and have experiences which can generate those sorts of emotional outcomes for me. So, planning my week in a way that I can actually touch those points become very, very a positive and, a structure for me.
So Gilbert, just to finish, what are some of the things that we can potentially assess as an individual that will tell us whether we're in the right headspace or whether we've got self-motivation to achieve what we want to achieve?
I think, two comments probably in relation to that. One is, if we look to the future and we understand what it is we're aiming to achieve, and in the future it has two key components. It has a challenge and it has a threat. And if we can focus in on the challenge aspect of that and just ask ourselves, is the challenge for me real, and is it identifiable, and is it giving me traction? Because that then fuels hunger and drive, which becomes signature behaviours about the way in which I apply myself in my role, whether it be in business, whether it be any specific role that I'm doing. The amount of hunger and the amount of things that I'm willing to sacrifice in pursuit of the challenge is important. Now, if I do those two things and I ask myself those two questions well, then I come back to my current reality and I can ask better questions of what I'm doing currently in my current reality that enable me to move towards where I want to go. And in its essence, that's your motivation and that's your drive. It's coming from pursuing that challenge and having the hunger and being willing to sacrifice, so that I come back and I look at my current reality and I say, wow, are my behaviours in my current situation allowing me to pursue the aspirations that I've set for myself?
Thank you again, Gilbert, for sharing your insights with us.
You're welcome.